So I'm here with Michael and Jennifer again. We're in a gym setting this time. We're going to be running through two different exercises today. One's going to be focused on lower extremity. We're going to use a step up. One's going to be upper extremity. We're going to use a bench press and see if we can point out any deficiencies. And then we're going to make a couple of modifications to it. So we're going to have Jennifer actually start with two 10-pound weights in either hand. And then we're going to have her complete the step up and do movement exercise as she kind of runs through it. So we're going to have her complete two repetitions just initially. So whenever you're ready, let's have you grab those. So we're going to start with her right leg first. So her right leg is going to lead. So whenever you're ready, Jennifer. One more time. I really want Jennifer to focus on the eccentric movement, so it's not just the step up, but it's also the lowering that I want her to really kind of control, and she's going to maintain it with that lead leg. Good, that looks much better. All right, so that one's good. Now we're going to switch Jennifer to an anterior view. I noticed a couple of things. Jennifer was kind of using momentum a little bit because I think of the extra weight, the external resistance. So this time we're just going to use body weight. I really wanted to focus on the core, not really leaning into the exercise, not really using momentum to drive up, but really focusing on extending the hip and the knee at the same time to kind of generate the power of the movement. So let's see that really quickly. We're just going to go like one repetition of from each leg. A bit slower on it. And then we're going to get it from an anterior view. So whenever you're ready. That was a little perfect. Awesome. One more time. Awesome. That looks much better. Much better. So now we're going to take a look at Jennifer's bench press. This time, using a little bit more external resistance than we used last time, we have a 35-pound bar, which should be fine. Jennifer is going to only give us about one or two repetitions from the anterior and the lateral view. We've adjusted the rack already to proper distance to allow her to unrack properly with assistance. And then we walked her through the breathing. On the eccentric movement, it's a big deep breath in. On the eccentric or concentric movement, it's a big deep breath out. So go ahead, Jennifer, lay back. The bar is right over her forehead. When I help her on a rack, it's going to be right over her clavicle, right over her GH joint. Something I noticed the last two repetitions, she's kind of keeping the bar as she's lowering it down right at the GH joint. What's that? It's going to cause a lot of shoulder problems, especially if she's using an increased weight. And so what I want her to do is she's going to lower it a little bit more to sternum level, and then as she presses, it'll come right back up to the GH joint. So go ahead and come back down. One more repetition. And what this is going to do is it's going to force her humerus kind of into the sides of her body and create a better angle for her to press. Alright, so now we're going to get Jennifer's bench press from a lateral view. We're going to take a look at exactly what I was talking about. Jennifer did a really good job on the last one, dropping the angle down into her sternum. And then as she presses to lockout position, it's going to come back up to her GH joint. This time I just want her to go a little bit slower, just so we can really see the movement at each kind of aspect there. Right under the